Hello subscribers, welcome by new episodes of the Mirror of the Throne. You can have to hit this red button so that you subscribe to my channel and not miss one of my episodes. And if you want, but let me now go. Vivisection is the act of burning, a cutting, electrocuting, burning, frozen, drugging, mutilating, and infecting animal, living animals with diseases. With mutation decisions of humans. One scientific method to make diseases being to humans been good for humans to animals is on this moment not infallible. It's not there. But vivisectionists still lie about this. Let me explain this in a many ways. The immunological, physiological, anatomical, and psychological dealing with the cell structure and psychological difference being too great to overcome. Animal research will not and cannot save the lives of humans in any way. Let me explain it in a little bit more ways. Are you aware that there is a way that vivisection doctors can show scientifically that humans don't get cancer from smoking? You know how they do that? They put dogs in one room, put gas masks on them, and let them inhale smoke. It is true that smoking don't get lung cancer in dogs. But humans can't. Also, the fraud of vivisection is subsidized around the whole world with billions of dollars that they get from lobbyists that fool anybody and that vivisection can be benefited in any way to humans. In any kind way of humans, for humans. When I was in an anatomical school, I have asked some students and doctors on which kind of animals they are studied for feline leukemia disease. They say, of course, cats. Then I ask them why not dogs, and then they say that it makes not so much sense scientifically. Then I asked them why use them cats and dogs for human leukemia disease. Their silence was the scum. Because vivisection, the actors and that kind of stuff, do that. They use cats for canine diseases, and so they don't use dogs for cats and horses for dogs or pigs for monkeys? No. That's also one of the reasons that's been absolutely defrauded. One other thing, maybe something that you'll find interesting. Also, if after this video you have to see the website with the title America's in Japanese for Men, they call it Arfetament. There's the website of one of the most greatest scientists in medical research, Dr. Ray Greig. Dr. Ray Greig, that's his name, Ray Greig. He can most likely explain it in a better way than I. But I can get also a little bit further, if you want. Also, vivisectionists lie about the viral of vivisection and refuse to use the following 10 forms of true scientific reasons. 1. Human-based clinical research. 3. Epidemiology studies and causes and disproduction of human diseases, cellular and molecular biology using human-based tissues and cell cultures, and in vitro adoption research, biopsy research, computer models using virtual reality models, and 3D programming, mathematical models using formulas to detect companies and reactions, case studies, human-based genetic research, and 10, trial and error methodology. Which, unfortunately, some people and organizations respond to the truth. Dozens of charities like the Essential Foundation, the America Kidney Fund, and the International Eye Foundation, don't name and view, responds to the truth and refuse to use outdated scientific evidence and use only the before scientific method that I've called, so just how I've done. To me, it is quite easy. I personally side always with the victims of injustice. And therefore, I choose, of course, the side of the anti-vivisectionists. Because I show the reality. Well, one other funny thing. After that, the vivisectionists have used the techniques on animals. Then they go to poor countries and use the tests again on Africa populations or other poor countries to use their medicals on before it go on the market. Also a long time in Western countries. Dr. Jerry Basic, one ex-vivisector, you have to watch more, you have to do your research a little bit more about him, because it becomes too long if you want to do anything that organic about them. I have to say something, when he was in medical school, he have learned that later on, that actually 99% of all the tests on animals can be put directly in the clinical, and that 1% that being mainly maybe one day substantial for human health can be easily obtained by non-animal true scientific evidence, just like the ones that have gone on so just a couple of months ago. You have to also understand that the vivisection, the doctors that still use vivisection and use animals in their own in the researches, we're not only frauds, but also addicted to an outdated form of research. Colin Blackmore, for example, how have sealed kids' eyes for fun, is not more than a true scientist than the monster. Than the scientists in the monster movies that we watched in the 70s and then 50s. Blackmore is not a doctor. He is not even intellectual enough to bring it to medical school. He's a pseudo-scientific fraud and salesman for the vivisection industry. You don't have to believe me, but that is still right. But think for a moment. That's what, yes. I bring only the facts. I've been the mirror of the truth. And I don't lie to you. Don't believe the vivisectionists that get billions and billions of dollars to promote their propaganda. I have no money, so I don't can give you a lot of propaganda. The only thing that I can do is show you the truth. If you want to know how I lie to you in this world, look to the money. Follow the money flow. And you will know what be the truth and how to lie and how do not. If you want to demonic more detail and video about this topic, put in the description. I can make a 40 minute video maybe for you, or I go a little bit in more detail and talk also a little about of information from the website of Dr. Greek, the medical man from Americas and Europeans and Japanese for medical advance, one non-animal research organization. We've been opposed to animal research when it's been done on for human diseases. So check that website also out. I have a link in the description below. Just stuff on some other ones. And now I will show you some quotes to make this to end of people in the history. An ex-vivisectionist have refused to use vivisection ever again, or been opposed to it in any way. And forget not to subscribe.